Good day and welcome back. In this video, we are going to talk about frictional force. In this lesson, we will learn about two types of frictions, which include static and kinetic friction. First, let's understand what is a friction. It is the force that opposes the relative motion of two solid surfaces in contact, or in simple, it is the force that opposes the motion of an object. We have two types of friction. First is the static friction that occurs before any movement of a stationary object. It is also can be understood as the force that keeps the object stationary. It has maximum value, also known as limiting static friction, which depends on the static friction coefficient and the reaction force from the surface in contact with the object. For example, we have limiting static friction of 10 N. If we apply less than 10 N force, such as 5 N, the friction produced is also 5 N to keep the object stationary. Static friction is self-regulating, which means it can adjust the value according to the force applied, but with the condition that it doesn't exceed the limiting static friction. Let's see one example, a question from SPM past year in 2019. We have a stone with a mass of 345 kg that is placed on an adjustable plane. A worker rests one end of the plane to move the stone down the plane. It is found that the angle of inclination is 30 degrees when the stone starts to move. So this is where the limiting static friction has been overcome by the force applied. Probably someone may ask, who applied the force or what is the source that moved the stone down? The answer will be the gravitational force or the weight of the object itself is pulling the object down. Let's see the stone on the horizontal plane. Here we can split into two vector components. One is the parallel to the plane and another is perpendicular to the plane. To calculate friction, we need to have two things. One is the coefficient, which is to be solved in the question. Another is the reaction force from the surface. When the plane is in horizontal, reaction force here is equal to mg. Hence, our static friction is equal to the coefficient multiplied mg. But let's observe the free body diagram where the plane is inclined. Here you can see that there is change in reaction force. Since the weight of the object is always downward, now you can see that in normal component, reaction force is not exactly equal to mg, but equal to the perpendicular component of the weight mg cos theta. So this is very important, which could be the common careless mistake and neglected by many of the students. Do remember to check the reaction force, especially when the surface is not a horizontal surface. We move on to the parallel components. Now we are actually considering the case where the force is in equilibrium, where the static friction is just overcome by the gravitational force in this case. So we have the static friction, which is mu r is equal to the parallel component of the weight, mg sin theta. Put in the equation of reaction and rearrange it, we have the coefficient in this case is equal to tangent 30 degree and equal to 0.5n. So remember that we don't have unit for the coefficient. So now let's discuss what happened when the static friction has been overcome. First, the friction will change to the second type of friction known as the kinetic friction. It is actually the normal frictions you have encountered in SPM physics, that is the friction force that occur when the object is moving. It could be either in constant velocity, increasing velocity, or decreasing velocity, depend on the forces and depend on the question given. So kinetic friction has similar equation as static friction, and it is also depending on the coefficient and also the reaction force. In fact, it is lesser than the limiting static friction, which you can somehow feel it when you move a very heavy object in practice. You can imagine it somehow. You will need more force to move a stationary object, but when the things start to move, you can feel that the opposing force is lesser, which indicates that the kinetic friction is less than the static friction. Let's see the situation in the previous question. When the angle is 30 degrees where the static friction has been overcome, the object will start to move down the inclined plane. But since the friction now is the kinetic friction, which is less than the static friction, and the pulling force here is still the same as mg sin theta, so we can observe that the force is not in equilibrium, and there is a resultant force applied on the stone, which causes it to move down with a constant acceleration. If I am not wrong, this is one of the experiments in SPM syllabus which you can test and try it by yourself. So here we will see one more question in past year in 2015. As shown in the picture, we have block B is trying to pull the block A and C to the right. Mass of block A and B are given as 4 kg and 2.2 kg. Coefficient of static friction between block A and the table is 0.25. To prevent the block A from sliding, determine the mass of block C. To solve this question, The first step is, of course, to check the equation of reaction force that is equal to the sum of mass of block A and C multiplied G. And then you can apply what we have learned in the example and question in the topic of Newton's laws of motion. For now, we are considering the case that block A is not moving, so the forces should be in equilibrium. At block B, tension in the spring will be equal to the weight of block B. And then on block A and C, we will have the friction is equal to the tension in the spring, which is also equal to the weight of block B. So we have the friction is equal to the weight of block B. So put in the formula and the values given, we can obtain the minimum mass of block C is equal to 4.8 kg to prevent the block A to slide. Now we move on to the next question. The block C is removed, so we could expect that the forces now are not in equilibrium. The removal of block C reduced the reaction force from the surface, which also affects the static friction. Now, the pulling force or the tension in the string able to pull the block A to the right. Hence, we can apply the formula F equal to ma and also the kinetic friction. Please remember not to use the static friction in this case because we only use it when the force is in equilibrium or when the object is not moving. So we have the pulling force or the weight of block B minus the kinetic friction equal to ma. Put in the formula and substitute in the value, you should be able to get the acceleration is equal to 2.22 meters per second squared. So I hope this is clear enough for you. To test your understanding on the topic of Newton's laws of motion, please calculate the tension in the string when the block A is moving. So I will leave the answer here, which is equal to 16.7 Newton. So if you have any problems, you can leave it in the comment section below. So that's conclude my discussion today. Please do leave a like and subscribe to my channel. I will see you again in my next video. Thank you.